kind of do a slightly different routine than we've done the last couple nights. Because today's a holiday.
Woo!
And it's Father's Day.
Daddy Day.
And, you know, Father's Day, you know, reminds me, you know, it's a great holiday about the passage of time and passing wisdom down to the next generation and watching them grow. And it's always a constant reminder that we're only one step closer to the grave. And so on that happy note, we'd like to dedicate this number to all the fathers who will die. Joining the other coolies in our banshee whale, But our truck was supposed to be here yesterday. A clear autumn day. As I descend the plateau, I can almost imagine I'm coming down Stone Mountain to the Imperial City. The effect is somewhat spoiled by the toxic smog spewing from the smokestacks of the tide flats. Even squinting really hard could not transform to ornate palaces shrouded in mist, so I hurry to my refuge, the Tacoma Public Library. I decided I'd feel French this morning, so I pulled a copy of Artaud, a biography of Balzac from the shelves, along with a compilation of surrealist writers and painters, those upper-middle-class frog bastards, playing at disaster while their doctor and lawyer fathers pay for their fashionable flats. And there I sit, at table, nubby orange library pencil poised in my fist over the 3x5 index cards so generously provided, tortured expression on my face, and the vague hope that some trust fund college girl from UPS would mistake me for a beat poet in the midst of composition and adopt me for the semester. Meanwhile, my confederates from the mission have wandered in, each focused on their own particular studies. Some pull collections of Man Ray photographs off the racks. No need for internet porn when there's new pictures of Kiki of Montparnasse circa 1925. Some just pull stacks to the floor and construct pup tent-like structures which they then crawl into, evoking a sense of security and well-being otherwise missing in their lives. One guy can always be counted on, crouched in a corner, Philip K. Dick anthology clutched in shaking hand, and muttered loudly about a conspiracy theory involving George W. Bush, Saddam Hussein, Mariah Carey, and a large buttered artichoke named Leon. Some go to the bathroom, never to come out, bouncing back and forth off ceramic walls until the guards escort them out at closing time. The staff surveys all this with thin, downturned mouths, lips cracked from lapis saliva, for all the moisture-inducing mechanisms in their bodies have long since shut down, except for the production of bile, which they have in abundance. Memories flash from embittered brains, generally along the lines of the excitement they felt and the knowledge they would be doing a great service to civilization when they proudly stood in the receiving line to accept their Master of Library Science degrees some 900 years ago. I know, I used to work with them. What is the use of all this goddamn literature anyhow? Hell, I'm even nestled among them. My 6 pages in a 500-page anthology filled with the dribblings of 100 other losers who thought they were clever. 25 years in show business for that? I'm published by the same firm that does Bukowski, I used to say to women in bars, which goes a long way to explaining my 8 years of celibacy. What a lying son of a bitch Chuck was. And surveying the scene, I think maybe the Visigoths had it right when they put the entire shithouse up in flames 2,000 years ago. After all, we'll still always have court TV. I'd like to keep on going in this kind of theme. I think the theme this evening is going to be institutions. So I'd like to do a number that's based on an institution. Actually, I was very excited about this because I discovered a band a couple years ago by the name of Richmond Fontaine. They come out of Portland, but they're great. Their main writer, Willie Blotton, it's like he'll write like a free verse poem, and then some chords. He doesn't even rhyme the free verse poem, and then chords, and just mash them together. It's a wow, I've been working so hard on these songs all these years, rhyming and trying to fit the rhythm and the words, and this guy's a genius. And so he opened up a whole new world of songwriting for me. I don't even bother to memorize lyrics anymore after listening to this guy. So, he's great. And now this new song in my brand new vein. Again, another Tacoma song, is entitled, And They Don't Give Free Cigarettes in Detox No More. His allergies came back, and his eyelids peeled and burned. Woke up in the middle of the night, feeling like he couldn't breathe, like always, only worse than usual.
simple step that Ukraine wouldn't break on stage. And pots of coffee only made the shaking worse. And what was up with that? And the only thing that kept him sane.
Detox No More.
Everyone, sing along. 'Cause
sing yet another song about the institution.
Yee.
Institution. Yeah, there's a institution in San Francisco, kind of in the neighborhood where the largely Hispanic mission district ends and Skid Row begins. And, you know, Skid Row, anything goes in Skid Row. And when you bottom out there, you can go to the Episcopal Sanctuary and try to regroup. At the Episcopal Sanctuary, there's not much to do. I stare up at the ceiling, I think of you. Never threw your letters, never should have read it, but I wanted to know what you never would have done. I got no one to blame except for myself, and there's no consolation in that. You never said don't do it, never made it clear. As long as you were drinking, you didn't care. I got a head full of heartache, I got two crowd trips. You don't remember anything else. At the Episcopal Sanctuary, there's not much to do. I stare up at the ceiling, I think of you. Rock-a-bye, demon. Rock-a-bye, angel. Raptured and lost. red paint peeling from the ceiling. I think of you. Watch the red paint peeling from the ceiling.
Well,
donate all your paychecks to Jerry Skippy Kids. And he keeps all your money cause his career's on the skid. You give cash to the American cancer scam and you change the merchandise. But no, not one penny to a baby that is mine. Blind babies hear them cry in the night. Everyone sing along. Blind babies hoping more gets out of sight. La 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 la. Blind babies life and time to spend you. You know the words, but how? Not everyone knows what a heartless bastard you are. But those blind babies do.
Around the world, what San Francisco, where else do you need to go?